Hi, my name is Anna Kang.
And my name is Chris Weyant, and we make books for kids.
You might know some of our characters in our stories, characters like Monty the Frog, ERASER, and our orange and purple fuzzy creatures from the series You Are Not Small. Today, we want to talk to you about one character in particular, ERASER. ERASER is the main character in our book, also called ERASER.
Tell us about your character.
ERASER is similar to me because I get frustrated sometimes, just like she does, especially when I feel left out of the group or when I work really hard on something and no one seems to notice.
I think ERASER and I are a lot alike in that we both don't give up easily. We make mistakes, but we keep trying. We also spend a lot of time with pencils and markers.
ERASER's different from me because in the story, she gets so upset that she runs away, which I don't normally do, even though sometimes I kind of want to.
One way that ERASER is different from me is that she's made of rubber and I'm not. We're also different in that she's still learning how important her job is. As an artist, I couldn't do anything if I didn't have my ERASERs.
How did you come up with this character?
Our daughter Kate actually thought of this character, ERASER, when she was in third grade. She imagined an ERASER who was so sad because she couldn't create. She could only take things away, and her hard work was invisible to everyone. I thought this was such a great idea and a feeling we could all relate to.
When Anna wrote the story ERASER, I loved this character. It took me hundreds of sketches before I finally discovered what she looked like. It was sometimes frustrating and I made a lot of mistakes, but like ERASER says, in the end, mistakes make us great.
My favorite thing about ERASER is that she wants to stretch herself and contribute to the greater good.
She's a smart, spunky, and strong girl.
What made you want to become a creator of books?
I wanted to become an author because books have the power to connect people and change their lives for the better. My high school English teacher, Miss Walsh, once had us write a simile or metaphor for homework. The next day, she had us all take turns reading them out loud. I did not enjoy speaking in front of people and sharing my work, so this was really agonizing for me. Most of my classmates wrote serious or poetic metaphors about love and war. Mine was, Mondays are like stepping on a slug. The whole class burst out laughing, including Miss Walsh, which really shocked me. They liked it. At that moment, I felt the power of writing. Miss Walsh liked it so much, she wrote it on the chalkboard where it stayed all week for her other classes to see.
I grew up loving books of all kinds, but especially picture books. As an illustrator, being able to tell interesting stories using my pictures is a dream come true. Knowing that kids will be reading them someday, who could ask for more?
If you found a whale in your bathtub, what would you do?
I would probably scream. Then I'd take a bunch of photos, and then I'd probably try to feed it.
I would ask if it wanted bubbles. Who's better at blowing bubbles than a whale?